Wow. Oh, nicotine. Oh, I just tried the Nicorette Quick Mist for the first time. That sucker is spicy, man. Have you guys ever tried those? It's like a hot nicotine pepper just busted in your face. Anyway, okay, folks, utopians, utubulars. Yeah, like that one, you girthy utubulars. Today we're gonna talk about getting started modding inside Bitwig, and more specifically using the LFO mods. There's three of them, and we're gonna look at them, and you're gonna think they're dope by the end of this video. Okay, all right, let's get into it. LFOs are like the breakfast you would definitely eat, right? There's Cheerios and LFOs, right? Did you eat your LFOs? Yes, Mom. Okay, fucking leave me alone. Okay. All right, so LFOs. Let's talk about what I've done so far. So obviously, I've hidden the browser. I've hidden the info pane, so it's nice and clean. I've thrown a polysynth on this track, made some chords. It's just an initial patch. There's nothing special happening here. Let's have a listen. Real exciting stuff. Okay, let's close that up. Okay, now I'm gonna load up a tool, but you could load up anything that you have in your Bitwig. External plugins, any Bitwig device, certainly you can load them up, and the principle is gonna be the same way. I'm using tool because it's more obvious if I modulate the volume so that you can tell what's happening when I mod it. Okay, all right, so you've loaded up your select plugin or device or whatever you got, and you click this little mod button. Click. All right, three boxes appear. When you fill these three boxes, three more boxes appear, so you never run out of boxes. Inside one of the boxes, I'm gonna click that, and let's start with the Beat LFO. Let's just start with a regular LFO. Okay, click okay. And there we go. If you don't know what an LFO is, it stands for low frequency oscillators. And in a nutshell, if I open up the settings here by clicking the arrow and slow it down, okay, let me just do this for a sec. Don't get confused. Now, imagine that this little dot is your bobber. You've gone fishing and you have a bobber on your fishing line, and that little dot is your bobber, okay? Below your bobber, you have some more fishing line, and then you have a little hook. So, as this, because it's floating on the water, if there's waves now in the water, because the bobber is floating, it goes up and down with the waves, as you can see right here. So because of that, the hook that's attached to the bobber is going up and down with it also. So now I can take that hook and I can attach it to anything inside of the plugin or device that I loaded, in this case, the tool. So if I want to do that, I can just click the arrow, which conveniently looks like a hook, click that. And now everything is shining blue because it's all asking, Alex, which one of us are you going to mod today, right? Like, it's the fish that wants to get caught. And I'm going, okay, I'm going to mod Amplitude today. Sorry, pan, sorry, width, I'm doing Amplitude. So now that I've clicked that button, I can go to my Amplitude, click and drag it down about halfway, like that. Okay, so what do you notice? Now, every time this bobber, sorry, you have to click that again once you're done to turn it off, so that you're telling Bitwig you're done modding stuff inside the device. Okay, so now every time this bobber goes up and down this wave, it's taking the knob of the Amplitude with it. Okay, all right, so now what you've done is you've effectively assigned a mod to your Amplitude. Let's listen. All right, okay, this is your rate. This is how fast are the waves, right? If you want a super choppy lake, wham, look at that. Look how fast those waves are going. That's insane, right? Like, you can't swim in that water. Listen. Right, yeah, so you can play around with that. One thing I'm gonna get out of the way right now I know I'm skipping ahead a little bit here, is do you see how it's going from all the way to my minimum value to twice my maximum value? Well, if I click this, it puts it in unidirectional mode, which means that it's only going up to the halfway point where the knob is set and the minimum to where I dragged the knob down to when I modified it. Okay, this is better in this case because I don't want to actually amplify the sound. I just want to go from the minimum to the maximum that I've set. Okay, all right, so now that that's out of the way, over here you have a drop down list which basically asks how you want to divide up the rate. If I want it in hertz and I have it set at, let's double click, have it set at 1, that means it's moving once every second. There's a one cycle of waves every second. 1, 2, 3, 4, so on and so forth. And if I turn it up, 50 cycles per second, okay? I can go into kilohertz, and now I'm doing 50,000 times per second, which is like not even comparable to a lake at any point now. And of course, then you have your beat divisions, which take into account your tempo, all right? So if in one bar, this is one bar right here, this cycle is going to cycle through once in this entire bar, okay? And then of course you can do that twice per bar, 4 times per bar, 8 times per bar, right? So half notes, quarter notes, eighth notes, so on and so forth. And then that's basically just setting how fast the waves are moving through time, okay? All right, over here, I can take this wave and skew it to the left or right. So if I skew it all the way to the left, it drops down immediately and then fades back in. Let's have a listen. Let's turn up the rate. Let's put it on fourths. Okay, so now what do you notice? Every time there's a quarter note, it hits the note right away and then slowly comes back up. If I skew it to the right, this is gonna, in my prediction, sound a lot like a sidechained compressor, right? Let's have a listen. Yeah, so basically you can play with that. Of course, you can double click it to put it back in the center. Okay, over here is choosing what shape of wave do you want. If it's all the way to the right, it's a sine wave. Double click, put it in the center, it's a triangular wave. And when you go to the left, it's a whatever wave. It's whatever the hell that wave is. Let's listen. Right, pretty cool, right? Okay, down here is the delay, as in how long until the LFO starts having an effect on the amplitude, or how long until the LFO kicks in. So when the note initially hits, there's gonna be no LFO effect, and then after however much delay you choose, it'll start adding effect to the note. Let's listen. Let me turn up the rate so it's more obvious. See that? There's a little bit of delay before it kicks in. Let's turn that down. The fade in slowly fades in the effect of the LFO. Let's have a listen. Right? So it starts off with nearly no effect from the LFO and then slowly builds it in depending on how long you set this fade. Okay? All right, and by default, those are at the bottom. Okay? This is your depth. In other words, let me slow that down. By default, it's set to maximum, meaning that it's going the full distance. But watch this as I turn it down, right? It gets a little smaller, a little smaller, a little smaller, till it's eventually not doing anything to the amplitude. And you can even see the dot is just moving straight through. And if I turn it up, it's following the wave exactly, okay? And of course, we've talked about bipolar mode, which just flips it like that or cuts it in half. All right, down here is what's triggering the LFO. Is it a note? So every time a note gets played, it starts over again, starts the cycle over again. It goes from the top of the wave. It also starts, you know, the beginning of the delay and the beginning of the fade in, and then goes through, and then when the note's done, it restarts again at the next set of notes, right? Or do we have it set to free, which means that no matter what, regardless of any note starts or ends, it's just doing its thing all the way through your track, okay? All right, let me get rid of this one. And let's load up a classic LFO. This is my favorite one by far. Let's open up the settings here. Firstly, I'm going to click the little hook, I'm going to call it, and I'm going to modulate my amplitude again. Okay, click the hook again because I'm done. And put it in, take it out of bipolar mode. Okay, so same thing as before. Now it's only going to there. Okay, so this time you have, here is your proper time division. So the rate is in hertz, right? So you can speed that up. Or it's by beat division. So here you go. If you click that and you click down, you have all your beats, right? Quarter notes, half notes, 16th notes, 32nd notes, whatever you want. And then you have your dotted notes, which, so if you have a half note, right? And that half note takes up two beats of a bar, right? One, two, that's a half note. If it's a dotted half note, it adds on half the value of the half note. So a dotted half note would be one, two, three beats, because it's two beats that a half note is, plus another beat, because that's, you know, anyway. So you can dick around with that and yeah, figure that out. Amount, same thing. If I turn this down, notice that it gets smaller and smaller, right? And go back to 100%. And your phase is basically, is telling you, if I have it on half notes and it's starting a new cycle every two beats, if I move it out of phase, I can start that cycle into the beat a little bit, or after the beat a little bit. So it's a little bit out of sync with your time, okay? And that's what phase is. We already know what bipolar is. And note trigger means that every time it hits a new note, it's gonna restart all of these features again, okay? Let's look at this slope here. Now watch this wave as I play with the slope. I'm gonna pull it down. What do you notice happened? When it gets to the bottom, it follows this slope back up to the top. Now if I go in the other direction, when it gets to the bottom, it follows the slope back up to the top, and it just creates an interesting looking wave, right? If I double click, back to center. And then of course here, you have your triangular wave, square wave, sawtooth waves in both directions, right? And then here you have your random square wave, which is pretty cool. Let's put it on eighth notes. Look at this, right? So that's pretty neat. And if you look at what it's doing to the amplitude, it's just jumping it around. It's like a bird eating seed. It's just all twitchy and jumpy and shit. Let's listen. Right? And then here is basically the sine wave version of that, which is just totally random. Okay, so pretty groovy. All right, lastly is, what was it? Beat LFO. And this one, I won't have to explain it much because you'll already know all the stuff that's happening in there. The only real difference is one, instead of it being rate as in like hertz, it's rate as in beat divisions. So if I go all the way up, it's probably like 128th notes, and all the way down, it's probably a bar. The other thing is you'll notice this global shuffle, this global groove. So if you want to apply global shuffle, which is up here, I have a whole video on how to set that up. If you want to apply that to your LFO, then you just click this button. And I think this is the only one of them that actually has that feature. I'm pretty darn sure, yeah. And so that's super cool. If you need your LFO to be affected by the shuffle, use this. And that's going to be appropriately in the beat LFO because, of course, when you have shuffle on, especially your global shuffle or groove, that's affecting the beats, okay? All right, which in a nutshell is moving all the even notes closer to the next following note, okay? Watch the video on global shuffle and you'll see what I mean, okay? One last thing, and This is really insane, okay? I can mod, let's open up classic LFO. And now I'm gonna click the little hook on the Beat LFO so that now I'm modding something. And I can go and modify the amount, for example, inside the classic LFO. So what's happened? Okay, the classic LFO is modding the amplitude, and then the Beat LFO is modding the amount inside the classic LFO. So I'm using an LFO to mod an LFO to mod an amplitude. Okay, and that means that you can just go insane and stack a whole shitload of these up, and you can come up with some really creative stuff. Not to mention that you're probably not going to put this on a tool. You're going to put it on reverbs and choruses and delays and flangers and stuff like that, tree monster, whatever else you got in there, all those interesting effects, and even your external plugins, you can do this too, right? And you're not limited whatsoever, okay? All right, so I think that's good enough. If you have any more questions, definitely comment below. Subscribe to me. I would really appreciate that. I'll come out with some new stuff on the regular in general. I'll try to keep you happy. I'll try to answer your questions. If you email me, I'll get back to you. And yeah, let me know what you guys come up with. What kind of insane chains of LFO mods that you guys come up with, because you can go insane. Like I think it's virtually endless what you can do with this. Okay. All right, kids. Remember, eat your LFOs, and I'll see you in the next video. Ciao.